This is Miss Lily. This will be her first professional groom, as far as I'm aware. The owner has been the one grooming her. It's okay. He has been grooming her, and she said that she does not like her legs or her feet clipped. So we are going to do our best with her to make sure she is comfortable. Sure she is done safely. So if you're not into dogs moving around and me holding, having to hold them a certain way, don't watch this video because I know I'm going to get some funky comments. I am working with living and moving animals, and you know, they kind of do what they want to do, but you know, I try to do as gentle as I can to try and help them, to comfort them. So we're just going to go a little slow with her and see what she lets me do. If worst comes to worst, she'll get some breaks, and then I'll probably have somebody to go over and help hold. So we're going to start with the number 7 blade.
Hi, baby. What you doing, huh?
I am not doing the 7 blade. What is the 7 I had yesterday? I don't know what I did with it, though. I'm pretty picky when it comes to my blades. I'm going to put on my favorite ones.
Jack, call 104, please.
I think it was a cane cut one. Yeah. I didn't think this brand makes them anymore. It's by Clean Cut. If you know this brand, and if they changed it, their name, please leave me a comment below. I've had this blade for years and I love it. I love about their other blades that they're selling in prison. Like, I've had this blade since the early 2000s. They're top level blades. She was a little bit anxious in the back, but I mean, it wasn't too bad. I mean, she was just kind of tap dancing. Her hair is really thick. It keeps getting stuck in the teeth. In the teethers. I'm going to have to find a red blade to go through this thick coat. Being a great princess. I don't know why I called you princess. Because you're the queen, boo-boo. You're going to be a queen when we're done.
Yeah. I know.
Queen Lily.
Lily of the Valley.
I know. Let me get closer to her legs. That's when I'll try to see her demeanor change. Good girl. You can get her first and she's going to be the first one out. I don't particularly like my new ones to kind of just hang around because it can be very stressful for them. So I try to get them done as quick as I can. So that's why when, you know, they're finished, they're finished.
so the tail didn't hang out. So I'm going to actually see if there is a one open and put her in a one. It's just so soft. I don't know. You're doing great, Mama. You're doing great, Mama.
Thank you.
right, Lily?
Thank you.
mess with that one, so she's going to be very careful. You don't want to poke her booty hole. That hurt. I know it would hurt. I had to get surgery after I had a daughter back there, and it was horrible. It was absolutely horrible. You're doing really good, Princess.
Oh, my goodness.
know, I think we can probably do a 5 on her head. We're going to do a 5 instead.
Doing great, Will. And
get to a clear beaver. I'm sorry. I got a pig up in there. Because you got to get the boys to come to the yard. You want to bring your milkshake to the yard? Yeah. They're going to be like, who's that girl? She's going to be like, it's Queen Lily, Queen Lily. I don't know what you're doing there, but I appreciate it. That's how we eat the size of your thighs.
Thank you.
but I don't know what we know. Ooh, you kicked me in the face. Please don't fart. Well, actually, I'd rather have you fart than poop. Don't poop on me. That would be a first. I've never been kicked on the face.
Doing really good. Ooh!
chug and she just, oh, she just looked up and pooped me right in my nose. I know she didn't do that on peanut butter. I have peanut butter. I don't know where I put it. That's how loose I'm holding these clippers. They literally fly on my hand. Are not, you know, showing me any signs of stress. So, so far she is fine. Her face. Because when I was talking to the client, she said she sees a lot of people do the schnauzer face on them. And I see a lot of people do schnauzer face too. I mean, they're pretty similar, but the face for an Airedale is more, it's more rectangular. She doesn't have a beard just yet, so it has to grow. But anytime I do any breed anyway, I always like to take a look and look at their face and review the face. Okay. Let's see if it shows you actually better. Now this book that I'm using is Notes by the Grooming Table. It is the pocket one by Melissa Philpeck. Sorry, I butchered your name, my bad. I met her once at an expo, and she is an amazing groomer, an amazing teacher. I actually learned from this book when I started the academy to groom. But anyway, this is your typical face. The sides and the top of the head get shaved, and then you get the brows, and down the face is more, but she doesn't really have that much of a face there. I'm only going to trim a little bit between her eyes. I'm not going to go down her nose, because it's not supposed to be shaved anyway. It's supposed to be left full. But when their faces are like this, I almost kind of do a little bit of a Bellington. I kind of just trim it all together a little bit. But whether you're new, old, having this little book around will definitely help out a lot, especially if you haven't done a breed in a long time. It's always good to have a refresher. I mean, now we have our cell phones and we have Google at disposal, but sometimes it's really nice to have an actual book, you know? So I'm just going to scissor this side here, trim here. I'm going to trim this here down and kind of just blend it all in. And then I'll go back to the feet. Now there are little, there's like little moles with like hair sticking out. Those are usually your guidelines of where you're supposed to stop when you're doing your schnauzer face. And it's usually when you start it, it's from the corner of the eye all the way down. And then usually when you're doing your beard, you use the shape just a little bit and it goes more down into like a elongated rectangle. She doesn't have that, so we're just going to trim it up just a little bit. I'm not sure if Mama wants to grow that out. I don't think that she necessarily does. So I guess it would be more of a modified clip. Very careful with the scissors. You don't want to poke her eyes. But make sure you have a nice grip on your muzzle. Not so much, when I say grip, not like, you know, you're holding them like they owe you money and you may go and let go until they give you that money because you won't cook the eggs. That's not what I mean. I mean, hold them to where, you know, it's a little bit more comfortable for you, but not so tight on the dog, but at least enough to where you can hold them in a position to where they will not hurt themselves. I don't know if I really explained that very well, but basically just don't hold the dog super, super tight. But you want to hold it firmly enough to where the dog won't get injured. That, or if you're scared of it, just make sure you use thinning shears. But you got to be extra careful with thinner shears because chunkers and thinners, they have wide teeth. So if you cut them, they're going to have these marks. I've had that happen to a dog before when it moved. I mean, accidents do happen. You just got to try and keep yourself, you know, in sync with the dog if possible. Sometimes that is a little difficult to do because they are moving and they have a mind of their own. Some of them are scared. Some of them just don't want to be bothered, you know. But you just got to try and do what you can. Honey, look here, Miss Queen. You are definitely a queen. You're acting like a diva. I'm not holding her nose tight, but I am holding it close. Because I don't want her tongue slipping out and slicing the tongue. Have you ever cut a tongue before? It can look like a murder scene. I think that a few years after I had started climbing, I had a really bad Bichon. And he was doing really, really good. He's usually really energetic. Well, he moved and I nicked. It was literally the tiniest, tiniest little cut. And it was gushing like it was a murder scene. And of course he shook and there was blood all over the place. It looked like I had killed him. But it was the tiniest little nick on his tongue. It wasn't even that long. It was like literally a speck. But tongues, they bleed really, really easy and they bleed a lot, just like ears. Come here, little baby. No. Hey. It's okay. It's okay, baby. It's okay. It's okay.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. You're doing so good. You're doing so good.
You're doing so good. Just let me out. I'll get that side of it.
So we go down to these legs. Chase the pads now. In her pad. So that's probably why she didn't want her feet touched, because she's got the knots in her feet. That could be very painful. You know, as owners, we don't think to look under their feet. We don't think to investigate, see if they have hair tangled in them, or, if something got in there. And when it rains, the hair starts to get long. And then the hair starts getting matted up from all the wetness, and then they're walking and they're rubbing on the ground. So you have a dog that has, you don't want to lie on your feet, always check their feet. I know we don't really think about it. I never really thought about it until I became vermin, so. I know, baby. But when she's out of it, it's okay. Them young, and you definitely want to pay attention to their feet and their face, because those are usually much more errands where you're going to get a dog that doesn't like it, and it could be for a lot of reasons. But make sure you do research on your dog before you get it, so this way you know what kind of maintenance you have, because sometimes breeders will not tell you. They'll tell you whatever they think you want to hear so they can get that money from you. And then once you get the dog, if there's any issues or anything, or you have any questions, sometimes you don't hear back from them. But that's not all breeders. Not all breeders do that. There are some really good breeders out there that will make sure that you are well aware. So just make sure you research your breeders. Make sure you're researching your breeds. And this way you're well aware of the maintenance. Make sure you know, you start them out young.
Vanessa?
Yes?
What time do you think Finn will be ready?
Finn?
Yeah.
I'm finishing up Lily. I might give her a break. I just have to brush him out.
Okay. He didn't complain today around his schedule, so it's not a rush. He just was like, about what time he thinks.
If he can give me 30 minutes, I'll take him out now and I'll finish him up.
Okay, thanks.
All right, no problem.
Thanks.
Okay. So I'm going to give her a little bit of a break so I can finish his other dog. I'm just going to let her probably chill in here with me. So this way, you know, she'll get a little bit more comfortable with me being around. It's okay. Oh, I'm going to turn off the table. We are an hour into this groom, and we are almost done. We just have to finish up her feet, and then she's done. So we've already done two pads. I got to do her back pads, and then just trim up her feet and her toenails. And so far, she's been absolutely amazing. It's still tilted. Yes. Okay, so we are back with Lily. She had a nice long break. Come on. I put her in one of our indoor-outdoor runs. She was just chilling outside. She was living her best life. So the only thing that we have to do is her back two poles, her nails, and then her feet. But she has been superb.
He says he's a sweet girl.
Yeah. So we're just going to finish that up, and then she will be done. I'm very proud of her so far. She's been really, really great. So I'm going to shave her back paws really quick. Come on in. She may kick like a horse. It's okay. So since it's raining, I have to make sure I get those out, whether she unfortunately likes it or not. I have to. This way it's going to help her. Oh, you almost got me. Had I not moved my face. I know, baby. I'm so sorry. The more often she gets this done, the better this will be for her. That would probably be more comfortable for her.
because I really wanted to make sure I got the pads done. Now the mom knows she's not going to be the absolute best looking dog. She knows she doesn't like her legs and stuff done. So I'm not trying to do show dog worthy. We're just trying to get the hair off of her so that she's comfortable enough. And then the more she comes, then the more we do her, and, you know, she'll eventually trust us and get used to it and realize that, you know, we're not hurting her. Okay. This looks like I put you right towards the edge. It's a lot. It can be very stressful. That plus she's almost 9. God bless her. But look, she does fine with the scissors. For the most part, so far after I said that she had to move. I mean, if she'll let me get this part on her foot, I would love to go over it with the blade again, but her out any further. So right now I'm just doing what she lets me do to her, and right now this is, she's okay with this. Not okay with that. Baby steps. You don't want to try and rush everything. But I had to get those knots out of her pads though. That had to be done. Clean up what I can on her feet. nails. I'll see if she'll let me go over certain areas with the 10. But she might not. So she has plenty of space between this noose and between this.
Touch the white hole if you see her, please. Touch the white once you see her.
Come on now. See if she'll let me get done. They don't look the best, but for this being her first professional grooming, because Mama says she didn't have this one hernia, and I'm not exactly sure when she got her in, rather. She might have gotten him late in life. She might have had him since a puppy. But maybe another girl didn't want to do her, so she just got stressed and started doing her own. I mean, a whole lot of things. But
hi!
Hi! I'm gonna get the flosses.
Flosses? About to get your puppy. But the fact that she's letting me go down her legs even a little bit. It's really very impressive. I think she knows I'm not going to hurt her, but I think she's still kind of weirded out by her feet. We are going to
tail. And she is done. She is done. She might not look the greatest, but I think she looks really good given the circumstances. I'm very, very proud of her. I'm hoping next time when she comes in, we'll definitely be able to get those feet a lot better. Baby steps. Baby steps. I mean, she let me get a lot off of her feet. And like I said, you saw the knots inside the pads. I mean, when they're sore like that, sometimes they just don't want their feet messed with. So I can sympathize. Anyway, I'm yapping at the mouth again. I'll see you guys in the next video. I love you. Thank you for the support and your watching. I greatly appreciate it. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit that notification bell. And give your kitty or your puppy a hug and a kiss from Aunt Missa.